All right, folks, it is Wednesday, and you know what that means, don't you? Weather Wednesday, it's back, and our very own meteorologist, Lena Jakowski, has another fun, new, and educational science experiment for families to complete at home.
Well, that's right, Taylor, and as these are always doable with low-cost or household items, which it makes them great to do at home with the kids. So let's see what we'll be learning about today, Lena.
Jordan, Taylor, today we're gonna make it rain. Last week we covered the water cycle, and today we'll be taking one piece of that one step further and breaking it down in great detail. We start at the ground where water from surfaces or bodies of water begins to evaporate upward. Water vapor can attach to particles in the air known as condensation nuclei, which can include dust or air pollution particles. The rising of surface moisture is instigated by some sort of a forcing mechanism, such as a front, a low pressure system, wind, or orographic lift. Orographic lift is when an air parcel is forced up upward from a lower elevation to a higher elevation due to an increase in terrain such as mountains or hills. Since temperature usually decreases with height, eventually the air and moisture cools and condenses to form clouds. The clouds become denser as more moisture rises and the water droplets grow in size through a process called collision coalescence. This is when water particles bump into each other within the cloud. Once these water particles become too heavy for the cloud to hold, gravity then plays a role and the water droplets return to the ground in the form of rain. The process then, of course, repeats itself. Because energy and heat are not equally distributed at the surface of the Earth, which of course we know to be true because it's much warmer at the equator than at the poles, this cycle plays a very important role in the process of redistribution of heat or energy and water throughout the globe. Like last week, today's experiment is simple and is only going to require four things. First, any clear glass or plastic jar or container works just fine. Shaving cream, preferably white, because this is going to be our clouds. Blue food coloring, which will be our water droplets, or rain, and water. So we'll start by filling our container almost full with water. Did you know that the atmosphere actually behaves like a fluid? So water is actually a good way to simulate the movement of moisture and air. Next, we're going to add a thin layer of clouds using the shaving cream to the top of the jar or container. Clouds form at the lifting condensation level, which us meteorologists refer to as the LCL. This is the height at which a rising parcel of air reaches saturation and clouds begin to form. Next, take your blue food coloring and begin adding water droplets to your cloud. Remember that density equals mass over volume, so the more voluminous your cloud, the more raindrops you'll have to add in order to make them heavy enough to begin to fall. Eventually, just like it occurs in the atmosphere, the rain will fall to the surface. As you can see, the food coloring mixes with the water evenly through dispersion. Turbulence and wind can also cause the atmosphere to end up becoming a mostly well-mixed gas. You can experiment with different cloud thicknesses to see just how much that cloud can hold. Join us again next Wednesday to see what topic I'll have in store. If you'd like to rewatch or reference this segment, Weather Wednesdays can always be found online at westernmassnews.com or in our app. For Western Mass News, I'm meteorologist Lena Jakowski.